The story of the Exodus.
This is a story that resonates deep within the heart of every human.
It is our story.
It is the story of a people in great need,
unable to purchase for themselves
the freedom that they were created to walk in.
It is the story of a people called out of bondage and into liberty.
Each of us, if we look deep within, finds that we were a people in bondage.
Although our taskmasters may not be named Pharaoh or Egypt,
we are a people who were once in shackles of our own.
Restraints that are the reward of the sin and rebellion that a life apart from the plans and purposes of God gives.
This is our story.
But God, rich in mercy and strong in victory, has made a way for his people.
He calls us out to draw us in.
In the story of the Exodus, the Lord made a way where there was no way.
He fights for his people.
The Lord our God has freed us and rescued us from the very things that keep us from entering into our destiny.
This is our story.
As we look at the journey of Israel,
we are reminded that we too are on a journey.
We're on a journey away from the shackles of this world,
away from the prison of sin, and into the freedom of God.
The same God that allowed death to pass over the people of Israel offers the same hope to his people today.
The same God that delivered his people from their pursuers and brought them into their destiny leads his people today.
This is our story.
While we were still in the bondages of sin, it was at that moment that Jesus, hero of our story, came to free us.
He came with the only key that could unlock our chains, a sacrifice.
Our story is not one of human might and strength, but rather of surrender.
Surrender to our Savior, who in the greatest act of selfless love gave his life as a ransom for yours.
That is the victory that he offers his people.
Victory that came as he gave us his life to set yours free.
He calls us out to draw us in.
He has called you out of darkness, and he has called you into light.
If you would call upon his name today, you will be saved.
Saved from a life that is far from the Lord.
Saved from the sin of this life and an eternity apart from him.
We are saved from something, and we are saved to something.
The same Spirit that led the people of Israel to the land of promise
now wants to lead you.
He is calling you, son.
He is calling you, daughter,
to come out of Egypt and to follow him.
Will you hear his voice today?
Will you follow his voice today?
He has called us out to draw us in.
He has called us out to draw us in.